especially Steve Rotherham, Metro Mayor of Liverpool City Region, Councillor Liam Robinson, Chair of Mersey Travel Transport Committee, and the Transport Portfolio Holder for the Liverpool City Region Combined Authority, Frank Rogers, Chief Executive and Director General of Mersey Travel, Andy Heath, Managing Director of Merseyrail, Hugh Jones, Divisional Director Rail of Palm Nato, Jörg Igax, Executive Vice President, Division Service of Stadler, and all our colleagues from our partners, Mersey Travel, Merseyrail, Palm Nato, Network Rail, as well, of course, the members of the press. I also would like to thank the organizers who made this wonderful event possible and worked very hard over the last weeks, especially the Stadler team, who was involved under the lead of Dominic Koster, and also any other colleagues involved from our partners, from the Mersey Travel Communications team, Palm Nato and Freshwater. Great job. Thanks very much. Our common mission here is to provide state-of-the-art public transport to the Liverpool City region. The successful collaboration of our organizations will improve train travel for members of the public by making train operations safer and more efficient. As much as the Mersey Travel Rolling Stock program is a landmark event for the Liverpool City region, it is equally, or it equally represents Stadler's first fully integrated project, and it's actually our flagship project in the UK market. So Stadler is very proud to be part of the Mersey Travel Rolling Stock program, and we are extremely committed to make it a great success together with you. Therefore, we are here today to celebrate this official start of the construction works, and I quickly would like to outline the program. After my introduction, we have the three speakers on stage, and then after that they change to PPE together with the members of the press and everybody else who wants to go onto the construction ground. After that we go out to the
Thanks, Thomas, and you're absolutely right. Thanks to everybody who's organised this. Probably the unsung heroes always. And it's unfortunate, isn't it, when you do try and organise something, you always try to rely on good weather, and we've not been able to bring that to you. I think that's probably as a result of me and Andy Bailey trying to bring Liverpool and Manchester together, and their weather has followed us to our city region. So I can blame Manchester for the downfall earlier. This is a great opportunity for us, isn't it, to celebrate really what has been achieved so far. We want our city region to have a 21st century transport system, an integrated transport system. But we want it because we believe that we deserve it, our city and our people deserve it. So to have this as the first physical milestone of what we want to achieve, to have the hub here, in Kirkdale, I think it shows real progress towards what we want to achieve. And I also want to congratulate Stadler on their excellent decision to locate their UK headquarters in Liverpool. I think that's the right decision, and possibly even on this particular site. And that will help us develop our long-term relationship. I think this has got off to a very successful start. I was very impressed when I recently met Stadler apprentices and went over the water, and I know there's a couple of them here today. That is something that I'm really determined to see whether we can exploit to its fullest, and to give those people the opportunity really of migrating from 1970s technology to state-of-the-art technology. And I think that's what we are going to all achieve together here. So thanks, Jürgen, thanks to everybody who's brought this fantastic facility here, and I think we're going to see what is going to be constructed next. And I'm going to hand over, Thomas, is it to you or to Liam?
Steve, thanks very much. It's now to announce Councillor Liam Robinson as the next speaker. Liam is the Liverpool City Councillor and is in this role extremely committed to improve railway on various levels. Liam was elected as chair of Mersyrail in June 2012 and was appointed a portfolio holder for transport for the Liverpool City region. Liam also represents Liverpool as a member of Rail North and is on the partnership board of Transport for the North. Liam, please.
Thanks for that kind introduction, Thomas. He's calling me a railway expert very politely.
Well, he's calling me an anorak.
Because I'll happily wear that badge. All joking apart, I'm already out and looking for a notebook with which I can take the numbers of the new 7-7 fleet when they arrive with us in the next couple of years. But thanks ever so much for organising today's event. I think this is fantastic because this is one of the first key milestones of making our brand new fleet come to life and actually kind of making sure for people that are travelling around our city region that they start to see how that brand new fleet of trains will be coming to us very, very shortly in the next few years. I think we should never lose sight of the fact of just how successful a story Merseyrail and the Merseyrail network has been and continues to be for our city region, particularly since it was devolved to us in the early 2000s. You know, lots of people talk about the kind of cliche that was Merseyrail, and I think that was the reality for a lot of people travelling around. But since it's been devolved to us, and there's been a much greater focus on our local network for local passengers, it's been a real, real success story. And I think when we stood here with one of the old fleet sort of as our backdrop, we probably should say a heartfelt thanks to these trains for delivering for us for the past few years. But it's thanks and in the sort of next couple of years, goodbye, because their time has been and they are going. And we've got to remember that this brand new fleet really will take the Merseyrail network and our whole transport network onto that next level. Yeah, I'll reference back to my closet anorak tendencies, but I get really, really excited about what the brand new trains will mean for our city region. When we think about how they're going to be a much greener, energy efficient fleet than what we've got and will really set the standard for the rail industry across this country. The fact that we're going to have pioneering accessibility standards, the fact that if you're in a wheelchair, pushing a bike, dragging a suitcase, you will be treated as an equal in just the same way that people who can just step on in an able-bodied fashion can. We're really sort of setting the mark for that. I think one of the other things that's really exciting about this is we're buying these brand new trains for the people of our city region. And it's the people of our city region, our passengers, they've actually been at the very, very heart of designing the actual detailed spec of what our new trains will deliver. And some great work that the team have been doing to make sure that the fleet of trains that we're buying for Scousers is being delivered and designed by the Scousers that will use them. But to make that new fleet of trains happen, we've obviously got to have a brand new depot to make that come to life. And when you think about how important a depot facility is, most people, when they're on the train going through, will just look out the window and see the sheds here and not really kind of fully appreciate all the detailed work that goes on here to keep the fleet operational. But for a brand new fleet of trains, we need a brand new depot facility to make sure that actually that fleet can perform to the highest of standards. And I'm getting really excited about how the modernised depot will actually give us much greater reliability and availability for these trains. And also, as someone that used to manage train cleaning, I'm really excited about the presentational standards and the cleanliness of the new trains being improved even further with the investment in the depot. So there's a lot to be excited about these brand new trains. Also as well, this project has been an excellent example of partnership working. Ourselves at Mersey Travel, Merseyrail as our operator, Network Rail, Stadler and Bam Nuttall as a local supplier that will be doing the detailed construction work. This is a fantastic example of everyone pulling together and actually starting to deliver a huge change and improvement for our transport network. I always like to say we're in what I call omelet territory, because inevitably when you're making these big changes, to make an omelette, you've got to break some eggs. And with this kind of investment going into the depot, It's a very detailed and a very complex project. However, I'm really, really pleased to say from all the updates I keep getting for David and the team that everything thus far is on time and on budget, and I'm really confident that that will continue to be the case. So today marks a great step in moving forward with the modernisation of our transport network, and I'm just really excited to see that flesh out over the next couple of years, and then we can all look back when we've got a brand new fleet of trains that will significantly improve our local transport network. So Thomas, back to you.
We'll lay toll which will stay and remain also for the future. I was not really sure, should we really talk today about trains or should we rather not talk about football? Because in the beginning, when we were gathering and had a coffee, football was really the major topic. And I have to learn a little bit more about that. But with the big success of Liverpool, may I get introduced to that part as well. Coming back now a little bit to Stadler. Stadler builds now since more than 75 years trains, complete train sets, comprehensive range of trains, starting from heavy rail to light railway vehicles to intercity to fast train operation, underground systems, as well trams or even locomotives. And as we are a Swiss company, we are also a leading manufacturing of rack railways. That means going up to the nice Swiss mountains. Maybe we have not a big chance to UK to sell that product, but we are open also to go in that direction. 7,600 employees are right now with Stadler worldwide, doing all this production engineering as well as then put trains in operation. And I can, with my division service, take care about all those trains. We have already set up in 17 different countries our work and facilities. Today, as a very important step for us is really that Stadler has started to build up his footprint here in the UK, here in Liverpool. As well as the fleet transformation with Merseyrail, we are very proud really to secure this big order. But also in parallel we had orders from SPT in Glasgow with a metro system of 16 units, or Greater East Anglia around London with 58 units, or close by with Sheffield where we have these seven super trams, or in Croydon with the tram as well. And Croydon for us is very important because that's the vehicle where we provide to Roger Federer always then to play tennis in the Wimbledon. Each of the projects and the contract is really unique and an excellent starting point for Stadler itself in this market. And Stadler is involved as well in many new tenders in the UK, which will definitely enlarge our footprint. I'm also very proud to have today with us the sales director for UK, Ralph Arwell. Whenever you would like to extend or even to enlarge the facility here in Mersey, he is ready to take the order. His order, he has the book with him to sign up the next orders. Now coming back a little bit to this depot construction. The tender started actually in January 16. There was a first visit to Kirkdale with all the interesting parties. And we gave a little bit the hard work to Dave and his team, because there was one guy from Stadler who walked around Kirkdale and made a lot of pictures, and he had to make sure that he is not going into all the nitty-gritty details. But it really started like this, that we had a good possibility to understand Kirkdale and how we could enlarge this part. A few weeks later, we were sitting together with BAM, and also at that time it was clear for both parties that we have, even in the tender phase as well, right now in the implementation, a tight timeline which we both have to fulfill. We developed then together a Stadler design of this building. Based on our experience in what we have in service in all the different countries, the main feature is really that we will have here a run-through shed, and we also have positioned this shed a little bit in a other part of the whole plot. And we also said we could do the whole thing with one track less. Then we received a comment from our customer. He said, design is not so nice, but it looks very efficient. And that was for us a clear message that we really have to go in that direction and really do further work to enlarge and do the whole construction. Coming now to the construction itself, here in Kirkdale, it will be a maintenance shed with two multifunctional run-through trucks. We will have here washing and stabling facility. We will have here new office facilities with different spaces, stores and workshop. We also will have here a simulator room where we can train our drivers and with the train simulator itself. And attached to this wheel lay hall, we will have further modification itself. Then in Birkenhead, we are going to have an additional washing plant to be really able to wash the trains both sides of Mersey. We spend here almost or a little bit more than £20 million. Construction actually started in August 17, but if we really look what happened at the ground itself, it started in March this year when we were doing the pilling for the new office building. The depot needs to be completed by 2019, because early 2019 first train will arrive for testing and for final commissioning. That means from today, in a year time, everything has to be ready to use for the maintenance facilities. Stadler itself is looking for this long-term partnership. We already have heard about 35 years. Actually, the whole contract is even 38 years for the maintenance, starting with the existing fleet. The building of the depot should not only have a 35 years view, but we also need to have here a clear statement of ourselves towards Liverpool. The focus of these 35 years is strong in order to have a high efficiency in the workshop and also well-trained people. Everything needs to be done in a way that we really have a high availability on the train itself. Stadler Service itself will set up his headquarters here in Liverpool and starting out from the country in this region. The existing facility will support us in the new businesses. Soon, a good maintenance facility and network in the whole country. We will grow and would like to grow in the UK with new opportunities, and there are many of good new opportunities on the market here where we can really take that into consideration. Depending on the new franchises with our units, we will build additional workshops or even additional support. We are very happy to be today with you and really to look together with you in the future to build up our long-term future. UK becomes for Stadler a very important country, and we are really looking forward to enlarge our footprint in this country. Thank you very much.